Let's say that you are developing your own best game ever, and for some reason PG is a part of your genre. For example, a roguelike. You have implemented the dungeon using PG and it was easy, because generating some random trees and graphs is rather simple, and now you would like to make some rooms in this dungeon, but do you know that other game developers usually don't generate rooms? Yeah, they don't. But why? Because it is really hard to make algorithms that are able to generate playable rooms every time they run. If you want to do this, you have to take into account things like visual design, fun, avoiding locks, and many other hard things. By locks I mean situation when player can't do anything because he's blocked by your bad level design. And it breaks the game so much, and you know, nobody likes to play in the broken game. Okay, so how do game devs solve this problem? Mostly they are making predefined set of room layouts, shuffle them and use them in the PG dungeon, maybe sometimes randomly tossing some less important decoration, and it works pretty well. This way, developer is able to control each aspect of the level design that he needs. Because at the end of the day, you want players to love your game. Nobody cares about your code. But what if we could mix the manual and PG level design? Let's try it out. We'll try to make a new room type for my game, TAnima. Our goals for this example are simple. We want the maze-like rooms. We want player to jump a lot. We want player to stay for a moment and think about solution. And we want some kind of danger that will make player think faster. I will make it manual first. It looks like this. It took me 2 minutes. Making 30 of them would take me an hour. Not bad, but do you have enough ideas to make 30 rooms of the same type? Yeah, maybe. What about 100? I will try to achieve similar result with some coding. Let's start with an empty room. Too dark. Add some light. At least we can see anything. Let's put some objects. A little more. Our simple functions works, that's good. Now let's put some holes to jump over. Great. We don't want these objects anymore. It is starting to look like our reference. And each time we run, the result will be different. Now we need some enemies. Great. Let's put some walls that will block players' movement. But most of these rooms are not playable at all. In a lot of cases, it is not possible to finish the room. And there is the twist. Do you know that your computer cannot generate the true random value? We will use it as our advantage. Before we generate the room, we will generate the seat for the random number generator. This way, we can print the seat along with the room. And next we export room layout and the seat to this some file. And now you can sit down and play through multiple generated rooms, noting down each layout that is good enough to be in the game. What's funny? This work can be done by anyone. Your girlfriend, wife, mother, younger sister, older brother, dog? If you have a really smart dog. If it takes too long, you can boost up your chances. And after some time you will have a set of great room layouts that you can use in your game. You might consider saving only the seats, which will save some space, but don't do this. Your algorithm will depend on implementation changes and random number generator, which can be different on a different environment. You never know if it won't change with the next version of your game dev engine. And it's done! Same idea can be used in any case of the PG content. Sometimes it is better to make everything manually, sometimes to use your code to make content for you, and sometimes you will be able to mix both these methods, just like in this case. I hope that my work will help you somehow. Thank you very much. If you like this video, hit these two important buttons down below. I hope that you like it enough to wishlist TAnima on Steam and maybe join official TAnima Discord. If you have an interesting idea or maybe you want me to focus more on some specific things, feel free to use the comment section. Your feedback matters. Thank you very much and see you in the next videos.